Today we're very blessed to have Abuna Elisha who serves in the villages and in the tribes of Kenya. He comes and visits every year, but every time he comes, it's always a blessing. Let's give him our attention. Let's listen to what he has to tell us.
Christos Anesti. Christ is risen. Truly is risen. I'm glad and happy to be with you in this occasion today, celebrating 50 days of the resurrection of the Lord. I'm so glad and I'm honored to be in the house of God today to share with you and to participate in the Holy Liturgy. Today the reading, really, I love this reading of today, of this gospel, of this liturgy. Yesterday I was praying the liturgy with Abuna Pshoy, and he told me to share. So I kind of read quickly the reading in Arabic, and I discover, even today, I discover more something very, very deep. Very deep. Which is not concerning Thomas and the disciples. We know the story. But concerning our behaviors, concerning our attitude in life, concerning the way we live, the way we deal, the way we act, the way we show, conduct ourselves to one another. And I like to read again the Pauline Epistle and the Catholicon, just to give background again. I liked the one who read the first reading today. Can you come and read for us the first and the second reading? My sermon, only 10 minutes, or less than 10 minutes. That's why I need to fill time so people can enjoy the reading, the Word of God, better than my invention. I invent always.
Sure. The Epistle of Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 20 to 32. But you have not so learned Christ, if indeed you have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, that you put off concerning your former conduct the old man which grows corrupt according to the deceitful lusts.
Changing behaviors. Yes? Are you with me? Are you with me? Changing attitude and behaviors.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you put on the new man which was created according to God in righteousness and true holiness. Therefore, putting away lying, each one speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath, nor give place to the devil. Let him who stole steal no longer, but rather let him labor, working with his hands what is good, that he may have something to give him who has need. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but what is good, for necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, just as God in Christ also forgave you. The Epistle of St. John, chapter 2, 7 through 17. Brethren, I write no new commandment to you, but an old commandment, which you have had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word which you heard from the beginning. Again, a new commandment I write to you, which thing is true in him and in you, because the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. He who says he is in the light and hates his brother is in darkness until now. He who loves his brother abides in the light, and there is no cause for stumbling in him. But he who hates his brother is in darkness and walks in darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. I write to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake. I write to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you, little children, because you have known the Father. I have written to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I have written to you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away, and the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever.
Thank you, sir. You get the message? So no need for sermon. Right? Do you agree? No need for a sermon. Today the Lord is talking to us how to change the way you live. We all of us come to the church and we say, Christos Anesti, you are truly risen. And we eat nice food. We celebrate many weddings, engagement, and very, very joyful time. Right? Correct? Correct. This is what we do during the 50 days of the resurrections. But God today needs to change the way we think, the way we behave. You agree with me? How many agree with me? Oh, yes. Very few. I'm happy. So if we focus on the gospel of today and the reading, yes, it speaks about God appeared to the disciples and he gave them the authority of the priesthood. He gave them the direction. Is that only for the disciples? Is it only for them? Thomas today, we call it Sunday, Thomas Sunday. Is this only for Thomas? And all of us will say, oh, bad Thomas, you doubted, and you really put Christ in a very fixed situations. And how come you doubt? You are disciples. We do the same. Yes? And also in the Passion Week, we come to Peter, oh, how bad Peter. We do the same. We make the same. Today, when God appeared to the disciples, how is the situation of the disciples? How do you look like? In darkness? Huh? On light. Room, imagine room without light, closed, no window, open, no doors, everything is shut. Closed, as we know. Yes? They live where? Fear. And fear come from where? Where the fear come? From no faith, as we know. Come from the devil, yes. So what happened? God came again to the disciples to take away the fear. Fear. Always, I am focused on me. I am focusing on my problems. When the Lord appeared, he take them out of themselves, right? Right? He take them out of them. As we have read today, the Pauline epistles, lot of doors there. Huh? Lot of windows are closed and darkness, right? Right or not? Is that right or not? I need to hear, raise or no? Yes, lot of problems in the first reading. God today came to take you out of this, to free you and me from this such a behavior, such life such attitude, which is very, very, very wrong. Today, Christ, when he entered, he led the disciples to get out of themselves, to get out. The problem is there. The fear is there. But when Christ come in the midst, he take out the fear. He take out every doubt that Christ was not to be again with us. No, Christ, the Lord, was us for the entire life, for the life to come. So the first point we need to focus in these 50 days, my behaviors, my attitude, in dealing with problems, in dealing with doubt, dealing with unbelief, we need to fix it. Otherwise, I will come to church, I'm acting movie. I'm just going around, and I don't know what's going on. End of the liturgy, I take Holy Communion, and I go home. I have nothing benefit. So this time of change of behaviors, time of change of way we live. You agree? Yes, we agree. Yes. This is the time for change. This is the time of resurrection. Every doubt, every darkness, it needs to be where? Away from my life. Far away from my life. This is the first point. Today the Lord opened it to his disciples when he appeared to Thomas. Second point in the gospel of today, when the Lord appeared to his disciples and he gave them the authority and he breathed in them the Holy Spirit. By the way, do you have this? You have this breathe? Do you have it? How many have the breath of the Holy Spirit? But I don't see hand. All of you? Gentlemen, do you have that? Yes. All of us, we have the Spirit of God. But let me tell you, why we are weak? Why? Why we are lazy in our spiritual life? Why? We have the same Abuna. When he baptized us, he breathed and he makes sure it comes in the tape, in the video. 3 times it comes. Nowadays, not a tape, it is what? CDs or whatever. Anyway, so when the Lord gave them the power, which no one can stand against them, no one can stand and say no. Imagine Peter, when they told him, don't preach the name of the Lord. What Jesus did, what Peter did, he say what? I must do what? Follow what God says. I must go and I preach again and I teach again and I show the people again the way. So here, witnessing. God gave them authority to witness him. Let us come to me and you. Are you witnessing Christ? Are you witnessing Christ in your daily life? I need yes to come from where? Yes, someone is saying yes, but the other shy to say yes, we witness Christ. Do you think the disciples, after Jesus appeared to them, they left the door closed? Huh? They left the window closed? They made big advertising, big panel. We are here. We are here in this upper room. Anyone welcome to come. This is what the disciples did. After Jesus gave them, peace be with you. Peace be with you. When the Lord gave them the authority, as I said to you, no more I live for myself. No more I live and I look at my, oh, big problems, oh, big disaster, no more. No more. My life became what not for me, bounded, closed to the others. Because who did that? The Lord. Christ did that in my life. Are we doing this, guys? Are we doing that? Are we witnessing Christ everywhere we go? Are we showing really the love of Christ, the peace of Christ in my life, every place I go? This question's for me before it comes to you. Christ need witnessing. Christ need strong nations to witness him. Are we doing that? So when the disciples heard that, when they saw the Lord appear, no more fear, no more looking at me, but I'm looking at others. How can I reach others? How can I show others Christ I have? Or we have fake peace. Do we have fake peace? Fake? False? The peace, the smiling you have now, fake or true? Yes. It should be true. So this is the second point. We need to look at it as a disciple. Are we witnessing or not? Because we are out. We are out of fear. We are out of doubt. Third point, which is very, 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 very important. I have seen it in the gospel. Feeling I am responsible. Feeling responsibilities toward the others. Jesus said to them, as my Father sent me, what? I will do what? But when he say, I need to send you, what we normally say? You send the disciples, very poor, and they have nothing, and they're easy to leave things. Easy to get things, to get rid of things. But, now our situation, economy is bad, and life is difficult. And to leave and to go and... No, this is not the way. This is not for us nowadays. It's for the poor people. To leave, easy to leave. Believe me, it is easy to leave when you are poor. Yes? Right? Right or not? Physically. If you are poor, I will leave what? I'm already... I always say to Mina. Mina spend with us. Where is he? Mina Saman. He spent with us 3 months in Maseno. I always say to him, stay in the carpet. Stay down. Stay. Keep down. Keep yourself down. I say that to me, not only to him. Stay down. Stay humble. You lose what? So, responsibility is very important. You agree with me? I am responsible. As the Father sent the Son, Jesus today is sending me. What normally I will do? What I will say? I need one excuse. We always know how to excuse. We always know how to escape. We always know how to say, next time. But God wants to send you. As the Father sent me, I am sending you. Go. This is very little high standard. So this is the third point. And this is the feeling of responsibility which come to us. I need to deliver the faith which I have. I need to give the faith to the others. Last point. The appearance today of the Lord to his disciples made them to look at the life which they live now in a different way, in a different eye. We always look at life with different way, right? But most of our focus in life is what? Only ourselves? What's our focus in life? Very good. Yes, Jesus, to follow him. Yes. But some of us, they lost this focus. They lost this eye. When I'm living now in this earth, I must live with the eyes of God. Imagine, God gave us his eyes. We live with the eyes of Christ. I live no more dreaming these things of the earth, material things. No, it is not my way. Not my life now. The appearance of the Lord to the disciple today, it changed the way the disciples' life. They give them a different attitude, different way of living. Are we ready to do the same? Really, if we do the same, we will enjoy truly risen and Christos and all these things and the liturgy. And we enjoy to come to the house of God. Imagine these fishers of men, they became the most wisest persons on the earth. Right? Can you tell that? A fisherman to do that? Because their behaviors, their way of living have been changed. I finished my sharing. And I hope and I pray for you that the way we live now need to be somehow. Somehow we need to rearrange again our life. Christ is risen. Christ is near. Truly he is near. Christ is near. Yes, he is near. He's about to come. And if he come, he need to find us a working in his field, not working in your home, not working in your whatever business. He wants you to find you inspired, working, bringing people to him, showing the people the way of salvation. May the Lord bless you and give you a prosperous life, spiritual life, to please him. And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.